Elon Hall is still recognized for rising to Top Chef fame as the winner of season 2. Since then, Hall has expanded his reach with his restaurant, The Gorbals. Here's the untold truth of Elon Hall. As the host of the cooking show Knife Fight, Hall enjoyed being able to eliminate his least favorite part of reality cooking shows, gross ingredients. Knife Fight is an after-hours cooking contest where challenger chefs are required to create 2 dishes at the Gorbals kitchen, from 3 selected mystery ingredients plus an available restaurant pantry.
If you combined Fight Club with Top Chef and threw in a dash of Crazy Scientist, the outcome would be the TV show Knife Fight.
When Radar Online asked the chef and host about choosing not-so-nice ingredients for the dishes, Hall said, "I would never do that." Elaborating further, Hall shared that terrible-tasting ingredients aren't worth it. "That defeats the purpose of the show, which is to make great food. In the end of it, I'm eating it, so I don't want to eat something made of strawberry milk powder and Skittles. And what's more, that great food is the prize in and of itself. While the show was produced by Drew Barrymore and full of culinary experts, it's a test of skill rather than a game for a giant cash prize." Hall said, "We have a combination of Michelin star owners, James Beard award winners, food and wine best new chefs, and still the only prize is a knife." The second season of Top Chef added the drama with perhaps one of the show's biggest scandals. 2 of the strongest and perhaps bitterest competitors were Marcel Vigneron and Elon Hall. While many have said the drama was played up for the cameras and that there is no true animosity, the two don't appear to be friendly post-show. At a certain point in the show, the judges were getting ready to pick the finale contestants, and the contestants themselves were getting ready to blow off some steam. Besides Hall and Vigneron, Sam Talbot, Elia Aboumrad, and Cliff Crooks were also present. While Vigneron was sleeping, Sam, Elia, Elon, and Cliff were drinking, which somehow resulted in a late-night head-shaving incident. With emotions rising, Vigneron was then targeted for the next haircut. In his own words to Las Vegas Weekly, "I'm taking a nap on the couch and Cliff picked me up in a full Nelson, tossed me on the floor. The plan was to toss me around like a rag doll and have Elon hold a camera and Sam shave me while Cliff held me down." Put simply, it was a prank turned assault. Show producer Shauna Manoprio later reflected, "Once we saw the tape, we had absolutely no choice but to ask Cliff to leave. I was very sorry to have to do so, as it was clear it was supposed to be a prank, but it clearly went too far." Elon Hall is known for having a sense of humor, and often the biggest punchline of his own jokes is himself. In a throwback Instagram post, Hall wrote, "In 2008, Matthew Deloso and I thought it would be a good idea to serve pork tartare. Hashtag trichinosis." A great example of Hall's humor can be found in a bio he submitted to Shalom Life, stating, "At the age of 27, Elon developed a form of energy that uses bacon to power a time machine. He has visited the Cretaceous period and has cooked velociraptor eggs to a perfect over-easy. He also visited an infant David Bowie and can personally confirm that he wrote the lyrics to the song China Girl." Clearly, Chef Hall is a jokester. Elon Hall and his son Theo are clearly huge Star Wars fans. For instance, Hall made a cute post in December 2019 before the most recent trilogy concluded. Hall said, "Happy birthday, my little Jedi." Describing that same occasion on another post, the chef said, "Jedi weapons, Disneyland, a self-driving car, room service, and channel surfing. A perfect birthday, I'd say. I don't think he's ready for tomorrow." For his son's 7th birthday, Hall shared a photo of a jacketed birthday boy in a Darth Vader helmet, captioned, "7 years ago, this little Dark Lord came into the world. He insisted on wearing this to the Last Jedi." And the fandom carries on in 2021, with son Theo pictured posing with a lightsaber amid red Sith troopers and a caption stating, "May the Fourth be with you." Speaking of Theo, Elon Hall and his partner Ayame Kawaguchi have been together for over a decade. In a September 2018 social post, Hall wrote, "9 years and 1 day with this stunner. After all that time, I still learn about you more each day. Weird that you haven't aged, though." A sense of humor goes a long way in this family, as seen when Kawaguchi shared a cute post in April 2020. "Happy birthday to this knucklehead. He's the best. First birthday in 10 years we've spent in quarantine. We can add that to the checklist." As evident on her feed, Kawaguchi and Hall's social values clearly align, as well as their love for food and fun. Kawaguchi posted a photo of her partner and son in spring 2021, reflecting, "These dang dudes keep me going, keep me hustling, keep me grounded. We are far from perfect, and I wouldn't have it any other way. Hurdles and roadblocks are nothing to us. This year has had us on our knees a few times, but we always get up and stand taller. Love you guys. Hashtag Rough Boys. While Elon Hall's food celebrity continues to rise, it's sweet to see his family helps keep him grounded. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Mashed videos about your favorite chefs are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.